Good evening. My name is Maria, and I'm going to be helping you today with your personal color analysis. Have you heard of that before? That's alright. So today, I'll help you find the best shades and colors that will become your personal wow colors. You know, sometimes we think, why is it so important? Well, certain shades actually will make us look ill. Others will make us the most radiant, the most glowy, and just fresh looking ourselves. Just by choosing the right shade of the color, you can change your whole demeanor, can bring more boosted confidence, more lovely energy to your being. And today I'll show you how we get there. So we'll do a few different things. I'll tell you about basic undertones. We'll look at the little library of colors here to find your best shade and your best color when we wear the right colors for our specific complexion. It boosts our confidence. It brings up youthfulness and radiance in our. You might right away hear compliments of how fresh you looked. What have you changed about yourself? Well, you look good today, even though all you might have done is put the right shade off top. The way it works, that the light bounces off of the clothing or things that surround us, and it bounces back onto our or just our skin. And then that color, if it's in correct shade, will virtually make us look younger and more beautiful. So you can truly make or break your whole look by just choosing the right color. So first, let's find what skin tone you are. Whether it's dark, light, medium, fair, all that good stuff, does not matter. We're looking at your skin undertone. One of the ways to find out what it is for you is to look at your beautiful wrist. And there you'll see some veins. Blue, or is that a green? So in my case, it's a definite blue. And that means I'm a cool tone. So just by knowing that, we can already eliminate all of the warm tones out of our clothing, out of our jewelry, out of our makeup. Because even makeup, even small things like a bronzer or a lipstick, if it's in the wrong undertone, can literally ruin your whole look. So, are you warm or cool tone? Another way to find out, for example, if you have too much tan, or if you're sunburned, or if you have makeup on your skin and you cannot see your veins, another way is to bring up gold and silver jewelry. So let's see. So here's a gold tone against my while it's not so bad, the silver definitely makes a pop. It just works a little bit better. Somehow, it creates a lightness and more of a refreshing effect. Another way you can also think, in summer, do you get skin burnt or do you get a good golden glow? That will tell you whether you're warm or cool as well. If you get easily burnt, most likely you're a cool tone. Okay. So once we find out whether you're cool or warm, we move on to differentiating between seasons. Each person is like a season. That's right. How sweet. And we will look at different colors. I'll show you some examples in a second. So these are the palettes, colors that would suit season the most, but personalized color analysis like this will actually give you a higher chance of truly identifying whether you need soft or more muted tones, or whether you need very bright colors like this top right here. For example, I am summer, so usually more toned down colors are better for summers, for the most part. But on me, bright, bold shades look amazing. So, you see, that's why personal touch is so much better. Okay. So let me show you some celebrities. Versus spring. Winter's cool tone. You think about winter, it's dark colors, it's more contrast, it's icy, but it's cool undertone. It's grayer and a little bit more, again, more icy. Versus spring, warm shades, glowing yellows, and you can actually see them just glowing from underneath through the skin. So spring, for example, is always lighter hair, lighter eyes in your color category. Whatever skin type, whatever skin color, whatever hair color you have, if it's the lighter shade in that color, you're probably spring if you have warm undertones. If same way, lighter hair, lighter eyes, but cool skin undertone, that makes you to be summer. A good example. Winter, dark, cold, darker kind of complexion, but yet cool. Summer, lighter, but cool. Spring, lighter, but warm. Autumn is deep yellows, warm, deep, dark tones. Deeper, darker eye color and darker hair color in your category once again. So, hope that was helpful. youthful a little bit. Okay. So then, when you look at the actual color choices, we'll all have an option to wear the same color but in different shade. You would think to add more yellow to it, or add more blue to it. More yellow is warm, more blue is cool. Does it work for you? Can you kind of see the pattern? Okay, good. So, in winter, you can see we're using all cool shades. There's no yellow, even in the yellow. Yellow is a cooler, more lemony style. Where in spring and autumn, it's almost orange tint to it. See? Same thing with summer. Blue is a very vivid blue. Pinks are more of magenta. Like this kind of color. It's very rosy. Pink. Same thing goes for reds, same thing goes for greens, and so forth. So, okay. So why don't we take a look at fabrics against your skin and see what color have the best understanding of how a color works with your complexion is to have the most neutral look. So we want to be makeup free, which I thank you for arriving with no makeup on. And I'll drape you with just a piece of white cloth, and it will create a more neutral blank statement, so we don't compare colors. It's easier for us to see how next color truly works with your face. Okay, so I'll place it right on you. So as far as library of colors, here I have only 50 shades, and they're not of gray. So anyway, there are so many more shades out there of colors. Today we'll just find some of the most wow colors that will stand out. It will be your personal beauty mark. Okay. So, I like to start with some controversial colors that people usually either hate or love, and that's yellows. Okay. So, I'll show you two yellows. Here's a more lemony, cool color. That's the color would suit me more. And here's more yellow color. This one also looks not bad, but it does not create this cool and refreshing look to me personally. You might see if I wear this yellow, you will see. face disappear more. So let's try it on you, okay? So here's a cool shade. And now a warm shade. Okay. So I actually think you're closer to cool in that sense. How about we look at some purples? So here's a cool purple with more blue in it. And here's a warm purple with more yellow in it. I hope you can see the difference. Do you see how it brings bluishness in my eyes? It colorates a bit more with my skin versus this one. So let's take a look at you, okay? So this is a cool tone. I definitely like this one already on you. I can see some lines right here disappearing. Bounces the light on your face perfectly, just dissolving away some of the smile lines here. And that's what we expect from the right cool tone from you. Here's a warm. This one gives you more of a darker kind of gloominess. So definitely cool here too. Let's take a look at reds. I have quite a few reds to show you. And here's a good difference too for you. So here's my kind of red, a cool red, has blue in it. You can see it makes my teeth whiter, the apples of my eyes more bright, smooth. My face somehow. And then here's a warm red. You can see my smile lines immediately. My teeth become more yellow. Not as white, at least. And it just kind of does not brighten me personally. Let's take a look at you. Okay, so this is warm yellow. Warm yellow, warm yellow. I'm sorry, red. Warm red. Okay. Here's a cool. actually you cannot even tell that it's raspberry red because it just looks like red, right? That's why you want to find some kind of app or some type of samples to carry around with you so you can bring it close to the fabric color so that you can see whether or not your wow color. Okay? Here's also a good example to see whether you're warm or cold is to look at tan colors. And same goes for gray. Are not really best for me personally, but here's a warm tan. I blend in. Here's a cool tan. Definitely looks better on me, but it's still not my perfect color. Here's a cool tan shade. Mm-hmm. Definitely a better tone for you personally. You want to try another shade, okay? Definitely. Which one would you like to take a look at? Black. That's a very good reminder for me. So, actually good information for you maybe, that lighter, very light, very fair skin types don't really wear black very well, even though most people don't think so, but actually navy is a much better choice for cooler tones. Especially very fair, like blonde hair, fair skin, better look in navy than black. So here's a good navy shade. This would be good, a black alternative for me. Makes my eyes pop, doesn't it? And what happens with black? Even though it's also a cooler shade, but it cuts me off. It darkens my eyes, and it just cuts me off. It cuts off my head, you see. It does not blend into my skin. It's too harsh often. So it's something to remember. And the same thing goes with cool white versus warm white. Okay? So let's try black and navy with you. Okay? So here's a black. Very nice, dark, rich color. Okay? And now navy. Navy is a softer contrast color for you too. I like this on you. So just consider looking for more colors that suit you the most, okay? And look at pinks. Let's take a look at pinks. I hope this session will inspire you. lighter shades of pink, again, cool versus warm. Would you like to try a lighter one? Okay, let's try a lighter one. So here's a warm pink. Actually, also not too bad. Just because pinks are really good on me. But here's a harder to decide, right? Okay, let's take a look. So this is more of a peach pink. Once again, it's not bad. It's pretty good still. See? So it's more still in a cooler pink shade. I think it's not as prominent as, for example, very orange. Gives you fresh look. It's lifting up some of the wrinkles here and almost kind of tightens your chin, creates more visual, beautiful firmness. Color can do that, indeed. Yes. So here's a deeper pink shade. Here's a warm pink. Also not bad, but the other one definitely makes a difference, doesn't it? But also not a bad option, okay? So let's do this one last, okay? So here's a cool pink for you. And I do like it on you a lot. It's slightly muted shade of pink. And this one's a bit more peachy, but still somewhat cooler shade too, somewhere there, but this is a warm pink. Like it? Okay, good. So I hope this was helpful. Thank you so much for stopping by, and I hope that this was informative. Good luck on your new adventure in finding your new. Thank you for stopping.